Well, that all went pretty smoothly last time, I would say. Hey guys, welcome back. I'm the Comic Foil, and we're going to... Pow? I don't know, we're going to Pow Bridge. Yeah, Pow Bridge. And right into another battle. There we go. Nothing new, this is just gonna be non-stop battles. Oh, maybe there is something new. Traitor, you've betrayed Lord Kane. I owe no allegiance to you or him, foul fiend that he is. You are only a mercenary. You do what we pay you to do. Here, I return your gold. I shall no longer follow your orders, Toad. If you are not with us, then you are against us. I will have the pleasure of killing you myself. Vile fiend! Aye! Oh. That's too bad. He seemed like a... like a guy. Ha ha! Thus fall all who dare to oppose the will of Dark Soul. Well, lesson learned, do not oppose the will of Dark Soul. Whoa, whoa. Warm-up sequence initiated. 10 seconds. 9. Okay. So, that's a lot right now. This is Pow Bridge. Funny, it looked like a wooden bridge on the map. Oh, okay, so I guess this here is Pow Bridge. The rest of it is, I don't know, Pow Pass, Pow Narrows. So what on earth is going on here? The titular laser eye. Okay. So it's gonna be shooting... it's gonna be shooting optic blasts, I guess. It's pointed this way, so does it just... is it all about this area here? This bridge? Maybe I have to just be really careful about who I take on the bridge, but... that's the only way I'm gonna get over there. It's not like I can... it's not like I can have Barbary and Amon carry people. So, yeah, I guess to start with, we just have to move everybody up and hope for the best. Tau, there you go. Everybody's getting... everybody's at the point where I could start leveling them up. Not leveling them up, but, you know what I mean. You know what I mean. Promoting them. Everybody's within promotion range. Ken, you're only level 9? I'm surprised about that. I use you a lot. I use you an awful lot. But then again, you're not really... you don't really kill people. You kind of more stand around and tank. So I can see why you haven't gotten an obscene amount of experience points. So, yeah, Gort, let's move you up. And Amon. I think we're gonna send the birds over across the bridge to see what they can start cleaning up. But, yeah, it's kind of scary thinking about sending all of... like, that's a lot of enemies for the birds to have to deal with all at once. So I don't know about this. That's a Silver Knight. A Silver Knight who killed that, that long-faced mercenary. Max, gonna head up. I noticed Runefaust isn't using bats anymore. They are strictly using Pegasi for their flying unit needs. They really kind of outdate a lot of their original enemies. Because I'm not seeing Dark Dwarves, I'm not seeing, what else did they used to have? Okay, what are you doing now? 8? 7? Okay, so the countdown is at 7. I'm assuming when the countdown hits 0, it fires a giant screw you laser. So... yeah, let's take out this guy, because this guy's the initial problem here. You hit so hard, Xylo. Aw, man. And Hans? Oh, Hans, I don't have a good position for you to attack from, unfortunately. So... I want to see if I can just hit him with a stick. Do a good stick attack. Yeah, Tau don't need no magic. Alright, there we go. Respect the stick. And we're gonna fly these guys across. Those archers might be too much for them, though. Oh, okay, alright, I think we might be in for some epic sky battles here. Epic is a strong word, I know. Gort, if you'll be my test subject for this. And... now I guess we play the waiting game. Okay, 6-5, targeting activated. Alright. I guess maybe what I should do is... yeah, kind of crowd everybody in like that, so that they're out of what I think the range of these attacks are. We could probably start on those enemies, though. Now, let's worry about the Pegasus first. Yeah, we're in the sky. Epic sky battle. 1 damage. Man, those guys are so well armored. And I'm in range for some arrows there, but that should be all right. So, you guys not doing much? Okay. All right, flyers are gonna swarm around Balbury. That's a decent hit. That's dece. That's pretty dece. I'm gonna focus on the one that Amon won't get shot at with arrows for me attacking. But yeah, these guys might be a little too tough for my birds. They're a little too tanky. I guess it keeps them busy. Oh no, and a third one's coming down. Yeah, that might be a little on the rough side. Oh, okay, and that's 5 damage. That is a 5 damager right there. Okay, but the snipers, the dark elves, whatever, they're not really responding yet. Gort, let's move you out of the way. I guess I'm just trying to figure out what exactly the shape of this laser I'm dealing with is. I'd rather see one laser attack before I try and outrun the bridge, as it were. Yeah, you guys don't want to do anything. All right. That's fine. I don't want to pressure you guys into anything. If you just want to stand there looking all fancy with your bows, that is fine. So, 4-3, getting close. Things are not doing so well here with my birds. Nope. Nah, this isn't gonna work. Okay, Balbury's gonna stay here and hold the line, but Amon's gonna back off, and then Balbury's gonna back off. Maybe we can lead these Pegasi to the rest of the group and take them out that way. Let's see how this laser does first, though. Ah, they're focusing Amon. Amon, no! Oh, dear. Good thing these aren't, like, Fire Emblem enemies that are gonna, you know, go around and pick on her. Ken. Alright. Okay. Alright, not a whole lot happening. I don't know, lizard folk, should you be standing there? I get the feeling you guys shouldn't be standing there. Okay, Balbury's doing okay. Oh no, Balbury's not doing okay. He's not doing okay, guys. Yeah, they made the flyers a little squishier than I thought they did. I wish I had a little more control over what order my characters move in. Alright, so is this gonna be it? Is this it? 2-1 fire. Let's see it. Wait, it didn't fire. It didn't do anything. Okay, maybe I had to give it one more turn. Oh, Balbury didn't even get another attack in. He didn't even get another turn to run away. Oh, okay, he's out. He got critted out. Ah, lame. Lame, 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 lame. Lame with a capital L and M and E. The A can stay lowercase, though, because this was a little bit my fault. Do I want to egress that? Okay, let's wait and see how this laser does, and then we'll decide if we want to do a mulligan, because yeah, this is mean. Okay. I'm just waiting on you. I'm waiting on you, Laser Eye. Laser Eye, you made this big deal about how you were gonna attack, and like, I'm waiting. Let's see it. Let's see what you got. Okay? Alright. And there it goes. Oh, it's actually firing on Ken. 11 damage. 12 damage. And it hits the Lizard Man. And it hits a Dark Priest. And it hits another Lizard Man. And it hits another Lizard Man. Got it. Okay, so even up there, he wasn't safe. No. Alright, it's a width of 3 spaces going all the way along here, but it hit all these enemies for pretty good damage. Okay, so I'm going to egress the next chance I get, but I have a pretty good idea how I'm going to be approaching this mission. Okay, so now that we understand how the laser eye works and just how strong those Pegasus Knights are, we have a new plan. We are going to send Amon and Balbury over the same way as before, but now more as a diversion, see if we can bait those Pegasi over to the rest of the group. Wait out the first laser eye, and then I guess we're gonna have to make a mad charge across the bridge. Yeah, that's the only way this is gonna work, actually. I think if I can make it to, if I can make it to this one cropping, I don't think people get hit then, but easier said than done. So, yeah, let's skip ahead and see how well that works. Alright, there we go. One of the Pegasi took the bait. I had Balbury there, kind of pulling his pants up over his leg, being like, hey boys, you wanna come ruin my run at this mission? And now I'm gonna ambush him with a pair of birds. I'm keeping them up there to do a little bit of damage to see if I can proc the rest of the Pegasi to start coming over. But once I do that, I'm gonna move them back and let the Pegasi just run into the brunt of my team. In which case, maybe having Lo there on the outside of the group is a bad idea. Who would I want to move instead, though? I don't know. Gotta move Lo when I get a chance. Come on down. Yes, taking the bait. Good. Okay, I just want that third Pegasus to come over now. Max, you can stay there. All right. Lo, get out. Luke, move up. There you go. All right. Chris can fill in that gap. All right, so now it's Balbury's turn. I'm gonna start moving Balbury back to the back of the group. Hopefully the others follow suit. Okay. Max, wait up. Tau, and Amon. Amon, you can get the heck out of there, Amon. All right. I think that should be what I need. I don't know what that centaur is doing. That centaur keeps moving aside. I kind of liked him standing in front of the laser eye, but that's fine. Okay, I got two Pegasus knights coming towards me. Okay, and that is perfect. That's right where I wanted you to go. All right, now you're caught in the middle of my group. Oh, okay. Now I get to tear up all that experience. Oh, he didn't proc. He didn't get the memo. Okay, that's fine. I'll take it for what it is. So, Luke, if you want to clip his wings there. Oh, no, I guess you don't. I guess he's a little too evasive. Alright, that's fine. Chris, don't need you there. And what's the laser eye at now? Okay, it's gonna fire next turn. Perfect. I can start my mad rush next turn. Xylo, you want to keep it real there. Hans, make an attack. Oh, nice. That was a good deadly shot. And Tau, I think you can be the one to finish it off here with maybe just a Blaze 1. I think a Blaze 1 will be fine. I think that should be good enough. Well, no, it's not going to do 9 damage, but I can finish it off with somebody else. Maybe Max. Maybe Max will get that attack. Oh, and he gets another attack at Max. Max didn't even get a chance. Oh, and it was deadly. Okay, that was a stunning blow. Maybe that was it. Because it was a stunning blow, he doesn't get to move as fast. Maybe that's how this works. I'm not entirely sure, but I am sure that Balbury is going to get the kill here. Actually, I'm not sure of that either. Yeah, that's only 1 damage. Balb. Okay, alright. Silver Knight's still hanging out. I think the Silver Knight is our boss this time around. And are you gonna go in there? Oh, you went on the other side of Balbury. That's not what I wanted you to do. Oh, that's a good hit. That's a stunning blow when he's out where I can't heal him. Okay, this hasn't been working out well for me. Max, if you want to make that attack, get him out of there. Okay, good. And that's a level 11 Max. Yeah, get ready to move, Ken. Gort, you get ready to move too. Amon, I think I'm gonna need you to help Balbury out here. Because I don't think this guy's gonna let up. No, I don't think he's going to. Double attack is nice, but that only really works if you hit twice, not if you attack twice. Everybody else holding their lines. Lo, I need you to do some of your magic here. Alright, and this is it. This is the attack. Here we go. Fire! Well, you guys planned this very poorly. You managed to hit none of my people and a bunch of your people. So, really, the forces of Runefaust don't know what they're doing. But that's fine. I get to start my charge now. Throwing Hans out in front, probably not a great idea, but sort of what I had to do. I had to just keep them moving, because I'm not going to have a lot of time here. Henri, go forward. Lizard folk aren't moving yet. I need to take control of that little cutout there in the side. If I can do that, I'll be good. Okay, he's going after Amon now. What should I do? Should I keep them there to keep the Pegasus at bay? Other Pegasus is moving. Not good, not good. Okay. Gonna move Amon up here to try and bait that Pegasus forward towards the bridge. Maybe it'll go after Amon and then it'll be much easier to take out. Oh, it doesn't help that they have healers too. Yeah, the advantage I get from this isn't as good when they have a Dark Priest on standby. So, Max, yeah, we're just gonna move all you guys up. Yeah, Balbury, if you can wait here and survive one more attack, then I think we'll be fine in that regard. Ken. Good. That's a good place for Ken. Gort. Move up as far as you can. Okay, I feel good. I feel good about this sting operation. I think this is gonna work. So, now we have everybody guarded who needs to be guarded, except for Lo. Lo's gonna get hit pretty bad, but it'll be worth it to heal up Balbury. There we go. I've been skipping over the heal animations because I feel like they're just not very fun to watch, but yeah, that laser, I'm assuming that laser's gonna take another 10 seconds or another 5 turns to charge up. Yep, warm-up sequence initiated, 10 seconds, 9. Okay. So, yeah, we're just gonna make a mad charge. Xylo, take out this Dark Priest. I will not abide by any more healing. Oh! Oh! Yeah, Xylo did not like your attitude there, bud. Neither does Hans, for that matter, but maybe Hans should just kind of keep his mouth shut, because no, because I can take it out right now. Okay, Hans, if you could just survive a couple attacks, it'll be totally worth it, because I took out their healer. Their healer is gone. I don't have a lot of time. I gotta get across the bridge. I'm already almost there. I already have some people to where they need to be, so yeah, Amon, let's do it this way. Let's keep the Pegasus Knight up here instead, since the Pegasus Knight decided not to move. He'll probably pick on the Pegasus Knight there, and this is exactly what we need. Let's do some magic, let's do some Blaze 2. Break their ranks. Something good, something good. 8 damage, and another 8 damage. Another dead damage. Alright. Man, I forgot how good my team got after a few more levels. Did she just learn Blaze 3? Holy crap. Oh my magic. Okay, Balbury. I need you to stay there. I know I want to dive you right at that Pegasus Knight, but it's not a good idea. So, those lizard folk aren't going to move forward. They're going to stay there until the moment they die. And this Pegasus Knight just has a vendetta against Balbury. It's not his smartest target anymore, but he just wants Balbury gone. He does not want to have to worry about him anymore. Silver Knight making his advance on the bridge again. Pegasus Knight going after Hans. I didn't want him to go after Hans. Okay, Hans took it though. He took it like a man. Or like an elf. Decisions. Ken can catch up later, so I'm gonna have him work on this Pegasus Knight instead. There we go. Good. And... okay, Henri, you can be the one to finish this guy off. Magic. For how much he has left? Yeah, let's. He has 16 health left. Let's go for a blaze too. All right, that's 8 damage. Good. What's going on down here? Nothing as usual. They like to sit and watch. Max. Move on up. Gort. If you want to get to this side, Gort. Because the farther up we can get you now, the better. Because you're not very fast. You're a stocky dwarf. Nice shot, Gort. Okay. That's another big headache out of the way. I got a new problem, though. Which is that if I hide them in that ridge, the archers can get them. And that's a huge pain. So, I don't know, maybe I should back all of them off now. Maybe that's what I should do. No, I'm in this. I'm in too deep. I have to try it. So, what are we at now? 8-7. Xylo. Why don't we try... okay, Xylo's not going to be able to do anything to the guys down there, so why don't we try just diving Xylo right in, trying to... break through this line now. They're already damaged from the laser eye, so should be fine. Yeah, that's gonna be no problem for Xylo. Xylo can eat right through that. Tastes like chicken. It probably does taste like chicken, actually. Hans, 9. Hans, I want you to attack, but you are too low on the health. So you will stay right there. How I do want you to attack. Not attack. I want you to use magic. Blaze 3. Oh. Wait, was that not a Blaze 3? Blaze 3 looks a lot like Blaze 2. Okay, let's just see how this looks, though. I thought Blaze 3 had better range. It certainly does more damage. It certainly looks better. Oh, man. That looks devastating. And who do we have now? Henri? Henri, if you would like to finish this pup off. I has 8 left. Yeah, I'm not gonna be stingy. I'm not gonna be stingy with my magic points. I'm just gonna go for it. There we go. Get out. Max, can you make it all the way over there? No, you can't, but it's alright. We have time. We have time. Time is what we do have now. So, Ken... We have more than time. We're actually in no danger whatsoever right now. Especially now that I'm attacking with Gort. Gort against a half-health lizard. Like, get out of here. You are beheaded. You're chopped in half. Great. Okay. And Amon... no, Amon can't quite reach. Okay. So let's put Amon where she can't get pointlessly counterattacked, but I think next turn will be when Amon starts helping out there. We can do the same with Balbury. Get Balbury down to that ridge. Low. And behold, heals for Hans. Hans for heals. Alright, and that's gonna be an arrow at Tau. Not really something I want to see, but there it is. Oh! Okay, Dark Elves do hit hard. I knew it would be a lot, but I didn't know it would be quite that much. So, let's put a pin in that for now. No, let's not put a pin in that. We gotta motor. We gotta take out those archers. This has the makings to be a really cool mission. With a slightly more refined game, this would be probably one of the coolest. Like, if this was a mission, this feels like a really good Fire Emblem chapter, not like a outdated kind of thing. Xylo, there you go. Shining Force is really smart. It's a really smart, really well-designed game. Some of the technology and some of the, like game philosophy wasn't really there yet because they were kind of pioneering a lot of stuff, but I think it's pretty good. Balbury, take it out. Ah, man. Because there is a lot going on here with, like, having to make choices. Can we do it this way? Can we do it, like... No, the range isn't going to be good enough there. Tau, you might need to take a break. Yeah, I'm going to have her take a break because I don't want her to get KO'd before the end of the chapter. Gort? Did Gort get faster? It feels like he got faster sometimes. Alright, Amon, let's see how good you can do at taking this guy out. There we go! That's a kill for Amon. You don't see that very often. And that's a level up for Amon. I don't think you're going to be seeing that very often either, because I don't think Amon's going to the end game for me. Sorry. That feels like it should have been a really powerful attack, but it was against Xylo, so it was nothing. Especially because it's a Silver Knight, so you would think, like, if they put that kind of thought into it... Ah! Dark Elf running away. Yeah, you can't handle it. Shining Force! Yeah, Shining Force! Because, like, Silver traditionally is what kills werewolves, right? So... I don't know, you'd think that would actually do a lot of damage to him. That's how it is in D&D. Werewolves get damage reduction against all weapons unless they are made of silver. So it's not like silver is super effective against werewolves, it's just their special defenses don't happen to work against silver. I got two more turns against this magic eye to get that out of the way. So, magic eye, laser eye. So I'm gonna get started on that. I'm gonna get started on that with Xylo, actually. I'm gonna leave that centaur to think about what he's done. I want to start hitting this laser eye down. If they all want to pile on Xylo, like, let them. Let's do a test here. Let's see how much... I was gonna say let's see how much abuse Xylo can take. Not as much as maybe I thought. This might have been a little over hasty. Alright, I might have respected Xylo's talents a little bit too much. Henri, move down there, because I don't think you're going to make it all the way over here in time. Tau, same for you. Which kind of sucks. It kind of sucks that I'm not going to be taking advantage of all the magic here. Okay, Centaur's out of the way. Good job, Max. Max is kind of in danger too, but maybe this will persuade them to go after Max instead of all piling on Xylo. That would be nice. This Dark Elf thinks he can run away from my birds. He cannot. Is it just me, or are archers, like, really cowardly in this game? Enemy archers. They're runners. I have never seen one hold its ground or, like, proactively attack. They'll attack something if it's already in its range, and sometimes not even then. Sometimes they'll just stand there or they'll run away. The archers are not very smart, and they're all running away too, so that takes care of any of my concerns, I guess. Okay, lizard folk or... Yeah, let's try to save Xylo. Keep saying lizard folk too, because that's how I say it when I'm playing D&D, the race that is the lizard folk. Gort's gonna get right up in this thing's face. Yeah. Oh, you got something in your eye! It's me axe! What are we waiting for? Alright, Luke. And you need to give some healing to Tau, because Tau took an arrow. Trying to decide if I want to say take an arrow to the knee or not. I do not want to say that, so I didn't say it, for all intents and purposes. But that was nice, because Lo just learned heal too. So that's great. Lo is turning out to be my best healer. I kind of hoped or kind of expected that it would be Chris and not Low, but there you go, there you have it. Okay, I can't quite get everybody across the bridge in time, so I'm really banking on you guys to take out this... to take out this laser eye. Xylo, I know we were worried about the lizard man, but your people need you. There you go. 6 damage, not bad, not bad. I don't think I'm gonna be able to do it in time, though. No, I don't think... I think there's no protecting those people on the bridge. Hopefully they'll be able to take a hit. No? Okay. All right, Balbury, that was a miss for you. Gort, yes. Gort, clutch. Clutch this. Take his eye out. Go for the eyes, Gort. Way to go, man. Laser eye is defeated. Yeah, you get a nice, juicy pile of experience points for that. And attack increases by 2, defense increases by 1, as if he needed it. Speed by 2? Sure. All right. Way to go, dwarf man. Way to go. And now we can... Yeah, you got a problem with my werewolf, man? You got a problem? Well, you just got double attacked, so joke's on you. Okay, and that dissuaded him. This lizard man isn't very smart. He should really be focusing one target at a time. I mean, I wasn't, but I was tactfully choosing the targets of each attack. Max, if you want to take that out, there we go. All right. This bridge is mine. Well, it's not mine yet. They got a few errant troops sitting around, but I mean, come on. I've pretty much cleaned shop here. Amon, nice one, Amon. There you go. There's another death for Amon, like you don't see very often. Pretty cool. Yeah, he's just gonna cower at the bottom of the stairs. So Luke, if you want to go make your presence known. And you guys can all move up, because the bridge is safe. The bridge is officially safe. Chris. I don't know, I kind of like Chris. I kind of want to use Chris more, but she just hasn't been able to keep up in levels. She's only level 4. I don't know, she probably learns slightly different spells than Lo does, because that's how they all seem to be. They all learn spells at different rates. I like that, that's a good way of keeping everybody unique. And Xylo, man, like, Xylo is like all I need, really. All right, this is what it's gonna come down to. Gotta choose somebody to duel them on the bridge. I'm gonna go with Luke. Luke, it's all you. Luke versus Silver Knight. Oh, nice. That actually did better than I thought it would. Yeah, level 8 for Luke, because I think this is just about Luke's last hurrah. I don't know if Luke's here to stay much longer, but I don't know. He made a good case for himself right there. Mages want to move up. Sorry, I haven't really gotten a lot of chance. No, mages did a good job this time. I'm not going to complain about the mages. Also, birds. You know why I love birds? Because they placate my reoccurring problem with bottlenecks. Because I could just move them in from the side and get some more attacks in, so I can work on this priest. And that's a level 9 bird. So, you going after Luke? Alright, Luke, you can dish it out, but can you take it? Yeah, you can take it. Way to go, man. You know, I've been assuming that Luke is a human, but is he actually supposed to be a dwarf, now that I think about it? Because he looks a lot like Gort from behind, but not identical. I just kind of always figured he was a human, but I don't know, maybe he is a dwarf. Maybe he's a young dwarf and his beard hasn't grown in yet. Personally, I thought dwarves were born with long beards, but... All right, there you go, Luke, it's all you. Yeah, he looks just like Gort from behind, now that I think about it. All right. Oh, he's gonna heal the Silver Knight. That's fine. That is just fine. You go ahead and do that, man. I know I shouldn't be giving experience to Luke if I'm planning on not using him much longer, but I come to the point where, like, I feel like I'm good enough at the... I feel like this game isn't too hard, so I feel like I can get away with stuff like that. But Hans, I am still gonna have Hans support Luke there, because I am planning on keeping Hans around for a long time. Hans, I'm just enjoying you too much. Luke, I feel like you deserve it. I feel like you deserve this last hurrah. All right, you guys move forward. Valbury, finish off this priest. Him and his dorky green socks and his green gloves. There we go. And Tau. No, this is all just gonna fall on either one of the birds or Luke or Hans to finish him off. It's not gonna be Max. Okay, Amon. Do we want to give this kill to Amon? For this, I am going to consider experience. Because, you know what? Why not? Luke. Gonna move you back. No. Luke, thank you for all you've done for me. Let this be your moment of glory. Take him out, Luke. Yeah. One blaze of glory. And the Silver Knight is no more. You may have beaten us here, but General Elliot will stop you in Pow. General Elliot, huh? Okay, what? Whew, I thought I was a goner. But I caught a branch and just hung on. That's pretty impressive to see a centaur scaling a wall like that. A great battle. I don't know who you are, but I want to tag along. Pel. Is it Pel or Pele? I'm gonna go with Pel for now, if somebody wants to correct me, though. A good job getting to that laser eye! Hurry on to Pow! Evil as a foot! With the laser eye gone, the Shining Force heads toward the moving town of Pow. The moving town of Pow? Did they take Pow and push it somewhere else? Knowing that Runefaust is gathering its forces, our heroes hurried onward. Oh, and that's the end of Chapter 3. All right. Okay, that puts us, what, halfway through the game? That was the secret weapon of Runefaust was a laser eye, which they just dug out of the ground just now. So, that's kind of interesting. So that thing was buried in the quarry, but it's like all super high tech. So are we like a medieval civilization that's grown atop a derelict futuristic civilization that met some sort of apocalypse? I'm not sure. Chapter 4, The Great Fortress of Balbazak. The Shining Force reached the Pow Prairie and discover that Pow was a town of wagons. Okay, you can't do that. You can't use reached and then use discover. That's mixing your tenses. You get yelled at that in English class. Alright, we're here in a moving town? Is this the town? Oh my gosh, it's another Howl's Moving Castle. Cool, or it's like a caravan town. Okay, it's a moving town, it moves around like a carnival. Have you heard about General Elliot? Well, just barely, so no. General Elliot is one of the greatest warlords of Runefaust. But I'm sure he is not evil of heart. He was the one who saved us when a group of bandits invaded this town. Oh, okay. So, I have a feeling we're gonna have to be dealing with this General Elliot at some point. Is that gonna be a problem? Couldn't tell ya, but we'll find out soon enough. Next time, we'll start exploring the wagon town of Pow. I'm the Comic Foil, and yeah, happy trails.